Hello and welcome to the command line of my CentOS 7 system. If we double check, we should see this is CentOS 7.2, so cats /etc/system, and then look at the release, and we can see this is indeed CentOS 7.2. We're going to be looking at setting up the LINBIT repository so we can install DRBD9, the distributed replicated block device, to give us our high availability. To be able to access the repositories, you will need some form of subscription, so you need to be able to negotiate with LINBIT to gain access through to this. But very often, when we're talking about high availability, we are also talking about you purchasing support, because you can't afford not to have that support. Once you get your order through, you'll be emailed how you can connect through to the repositories. And we can actually take this step by step, but the first thing, this is easy enough, just move into the temp directory. From the temp directory, we can use wget and download a Python script. So we see there we've been able to download it. With it downloaded, of course, we just need to do a chmod plus x and then linbit to make it executable. We now go through and run the script. Now the first thing it's going to do is ask us to authenticate, and it's connecting through to, if you like, my LINBIT. So we need to put in the user account details that we were provided. Now it's going to write our registration data, and the registration data is also going to include the hash that we must use. So we can choose yes to write to that. Then it's asking us if we want to create the repository file. To be honest, it doesn't do a lot here. We might as well create it, but it's only going to create an empty file anyway. So if we choose yes, and it looks on my system it already exists, but I'll overwrite it so we will see what happens, and add in the repository signing keys. And when we go through then, let's just clear out the screen. Now if we move in then to our etc and yum.repos.d directory, when we cat out the LINBIT repo, it's empty. So even though I say it does create it for you, it doesn't do a lot of work, does it really? So this is where we need to get in and create it. It's also where your hash will come in. When I go through and take a look at, let's cat this out, so /var/lib and then drbd support, and then look at the registration.json, in this file it will actually have our hash. So we can see there the node hash, and that's the hash value that we must use. I can then go through and copy this out. Obviously I can't let you have my hash, but I can go through and copy this out. We can then go through and edit the configuration file. So vim linbit.repo. And the repository file is going to look, well, pretty much like any of our repository files. They're not difficult really to go in and create. So we can go through and give this an ID. So we'll go in and to insert, give it an ID. So LINBIT, then set up its name. So I'm just going to go name LINBIT. So name equals LINBIT, then the base URL. So the base URL is going to be HTTP. And then running through to packages.linbit.com/. Now this is where we then put in our hash. And then /at the end of the hash. And then tell it to go through, look for yum. And then the version that we're using. So if I'm using CentOS, we still go in and put rel 7.2. And then the component that we want, so DRBD-9.0, and then the architecture. So of course it's going to be 64-bit on CentOS 7. So x86_64. So that's the base URL that we want. And then we can go through and tell it to do a check or not. So GPG check equals 0. We don't need that turned on. And then we'll make sure that it's enabled. Go through and save this. We now go through and do a yum repo list. So we can see there we've got our repositories. If we then go through and run a make cache to update the cache. And now we can go through and make one final change to our repositories. We want to make sure that we're only getting from the LINBIT repositories. So I'm just going to go into Vi and then my CentOS base repo. And if we then jump down to the extras, I'm just adding in a line here. And we're just going to go through and tell it to exclude equals and DRBD star and kmod dash DRBD star. Just to make sure that we're not going to use them from this repository, from the extras repository. We're only going to get them from the repository that we want, the LINBIT repository. Now we can go through and install. So yum install minus y, just to go ahead with it, drbd and kmod-drbd. Now do be aware that that final kernel module does seem to take a little bit of a while to install. So just give it time to run through the install. But with this installed, we should now be able to get information from it. It doesn't really matter where we are. Let's move back to the root user's home directory. And if we use mod info, and we can then go through and look at drbd. So we're looking at the kernel module drbd. And we can then go through and look at the version that we're using. So we can see that this is version 9.0.2-1. But hopefully this gives you an idea in setting up your CentOS repositories to be able to access the supported LINBIT DRBD9.